In this video, I'm going to share how to run a retreat business and do it in a way that's profitable and also lifestyle friendly. First, I'm going to share a little bit about my story so you understand how I learned what I'm going to tell you. I'm also going to share some of the problems that people run into and the solutions for those problems, and then get into the three core things that I believe form the foundation and the framework for a really solid retreat business for the long haul. I first started my business over 13 years ago, in 2007, but I spent the first 7 years of my business really not with a very good business model. I wasn't really doing retreats back then. Instead, I was a speaker, trainer. I used to lead workshops and seminars, and then I started hosting big events and getting really burnt out on all these different things that I was doing. And so I finally had a breakdown, and finally my health caught up with me, my business started to fall apart, just everything started to dissolve at the same time. And so I had to figure out a better way. That's when I discovered the small events, the retreats. I discovered it because I actually went to a retreat, had a really powerful experience, and witnessed how the leader of the retreat was able to make an offer at this retreat for a one-year program. And I saw all the people around me, there were 10 of us in the room, I saw 7 of those people sign up for this one-year program, and I thought to myself, why am I doing all this work selling these 100, 200, 500 person events for $50 or $100 when I could instead do this retreat model, sell a lot less, have a lot lower production costs, and then get clients for the long haul? So that was the big wake-up call for me. I witnessed a better way. And from that, witnessing it, I decided to sign up with that mentor and learn how he was doing it. So I spent 2 years working with that mentor, him teaching me basically how to run this model. And so I did that. I started doing this model. My business started to grow. It grew very quickly in the first year. It grew almost quadruple in 1 year. And then I started to tweak it. I started to see how I could make the model more aligned to fit me and a little bit more graceful and more easy in the process. So here's one of the problems that I faced in the beginning and that I see a lot of my clients run into, which is that they overfocus on the production component of the retreats and the retreat business and underfocus on the business essentials that underpin the business. So in this video, we're going to talk about the underpinnings of the business because I have tons of videos already about how to run retreats and how to do the production and logistics. So this video is really about the retreat business as a whole, how to set it up so that it has stability and scalability and generates monthly recurring revenues. Another big issue that people run into is that filling retreats can get heavy after a while, or even right in the beginning. If you're constantly having to fill a retreat, especially if your pricing is too low, then it can start to get old fast to be constantly having to put people into your retreats. That's why I think my model, it fixes that problem. I'm gonna share with you exactly how it does that. So as I share these strategies with you, just notice maybe some of these strategies do apply to you and maybe some of them don't. So just take what works for you and disregard what doesn't. So what I'm looking for always is how can I create something that's stable and that's replicatable and that doesn't require me to reinvent the wheel each time. So when I first started doing retreats, my creator was full of ideas. I can do a retreat about this, and then I'll do a retreat about that, and then I'll do another retreat. And I was constantly trying to create new retreats and fill them and trying to make them interesting and unique each time. That was very draining. And it was draining, not from the creative standpoint. I loved coming up with the ideas, but it became very draining from a marketing standpoint and from a fulfillment standpoint. Let's talk about marketing first. So on the marketing side, every time I created a new retreat concept, I needed a new landing page. I needed a new brochure. I needed new marketing copy for the world. I needed new emails to send out. So I had to reinvent everything around this retreat every single time. From a fulfillment standpoint, same thing. Because each retreat was different, I would find new venues and I would create new content. And that just kept me in the hustle mode that I had tried to escape from in the first place. I remember my very first year of doing retreats, I did 11 retreats in 1 year. I would also say, that's About seven too many. So over the years, what I've done to tweak this model, make it more graceful, more easy, is number one, is I created one core retreat to start with. Meaning that, I don't know if you're familiar with Tony Robbins, right? Tony Robbins has all these different things that he has or offers, but the number one thing that he starts with that almost everyone begins with is unleash the power within. This one event that they've done over and over and over. They've optimized it and they've gotten it to such a, they've fine-tuned it to such a point that now they deliver it and they know what they're going to create from it. They can project and predict the outcome of that event. Same goes if you're familiar with Landmark Education. They have the Landmark Forum. Landmark Forum is where people begin. Everybody starts with the Landmark Forum. It's a prerequisite for everything else that they do. So I recommend that model for a retreat business to make it more graceful and easy. Find one thing that you can execute and modify and optimize every single time and make it better. The second thing I do with that is I only do it 4 times a year, 1 time per season. So when I first started doing retreats, I was kind of stuck in my head. I had this limiting belief that they had to be 10 people, no more. And that's because the first retreat that I went to was 10 people, no more. So I spent 2, maybe 3 years limiting my retreats, and that meant I had to do more and more retreats, which was stressful and had more production cost. But finally, I realized the key to scale was to be able to grow beyond 10 people. Once I was able to unlock that in my mind, and I was able to unlock that in my marketing, everything opened up. Now that I could have 20 or 25 or even 30 people, which is kind of where I feel like a retreat maxes out, now that I could have that many people together, I only needed to do the retreat 4 times a year, once per season. And let me tell you something, 4 times a year, once per season, is exactly the rhythm that works for me. Now, that might not work for you, but for me, that gives me 12 weeks between each retreat to market and sell the next one. And because it's the same retreat delivered every quarter, like I can get a client or a prospect that's interested and not available for the next one and enroll them in the one after that. So that's what I recommend as a framework, creating one signature retreat that you deliver again and again, that you optimize and you improve and iterate each and every time. Now, the second part of it is that it doesn't end in the retreat. And in fact, I like to say the money isn't in that retreat. That signature retreat is really just where the journey begins. And in fact, that signature retreat is what sets you up for true lasting transformation. So the second big thing to get from this video is that the retreat itself isn't where the money is actually at. It isn't even where the transformation is really at. In a retreat, you cannot truly transform someone's identity or life long-term. People can have a big breakthrough in a retreat, a huge realization. They can recognize a blind spot. They can heal something that's been troubling them for a long time. But what you can do in 3 or 4 or 5 days is nothing compared to what you could do over a year. And so what I recommend is at your retreat, you deliver massive value and you make that a platform for people to step into a longer-term program with you. This is what I call the big back end. And the big back end is what can drive monthly recurring revenues for you, which makes your business more stable, more scalable, and it drives lasting support and transformation for your clients. So I'm a big believer in having that breakthrough experience, that retreat, and then some sort of mastery program for a year. And then that mastery program is some sort of group experience. Now, here's the coolest part. That's where I get to play with the retreats. Instead of playing with the upfront retreats and having to market and sell all these retreats all the time, instead I get creative and I just offer it to the people who are working with me for a whole year. So in that 1 year program, that 1 year group program, I include in there 2 exclusive retreats just for them. That's where I can get creative. That's where I can find cool venues because I don't have to market it. I just put it out to my crew and they all want to come because they're already committed. So now you get the experience of having the graceful, easy revenue stream And you have the experience of these exciting, new, and fun experiences. So you're not giving up anything. You're just organizing it in a way that makes more sense and makes it a lot easier for you. Before I get to the last thing that I want to share with you, I invite you to check out my entire retreat business playlist. I have so many videos there about how to run retreats, how to design content for them, how to make money, how to market them. I highly encourage you to check that out. So the last thing I want to share is what comes after that big back end, which I now call the even bigger back end. The even bigger back end is those people that have been with you beyond 1 year. So when I started my retreat business, we got to the end of that first year, and my very first client, Leanne Webster, who you've probably heard me talk about, says, "Hey, Michelle, what's next? Like, is that it? Are you kicking me out of the group or can I stay?" And I didn't even know, like I hadn't thought about that. So I went to my mentor, who's Mark LeBlanc at the time, and I said, "Mark, I've got this client that's coming up on her first year. She wants to keep working with me. She wants to stay in the Inner Circle, which is my back end program." And he goes, "Well, why don't you offer her a 2-year agreement?" I was like, "Can I do that? Is that okay?" He's like, "Of course you can do that. That's why you're an entrepreneur. You can do a contract for however long you want." So I went to Leanne and I suggested this opportunity. I gave her a really sweet deal for committing to the 2 years together. And I named the new program Leadership Cabinet. Well, she loved it. She signed up for it. And now here we are 6 years later. And we have almost as many people in our Leadership Cabinet as we have in our first year, because that many people have stayed the course with us. And the beautiful part of this is that those people actually now come back and help me deliver my breakthrough signature retreat, that upfront retreat that I first told you about. Those people come and help, and that's what's allowed us and enabled us to scale it even bigger, because they come just to support as part of their leadership cabinet agreement. So there you have it. That's a model that's sustainable and scalable for a retreat business that I highly recommend. So even if that full model doesn't work for you, I hope some of those elements did. And if you're interested in working with me personally and learning more about if and how I can help you grow and scale your retreat business, go to superstaractivator.com/go. You can click on the link below and set up time to talk with me on my calendar or talk with someone on my team. I'll see you soon.